It is said that if the Schlachthof did not exist, Wiesbaden's cultural life would be in trouble. Be it bands like Motorhead, Sportfreunde Stiller or Fettes Brot, they've all performed here. An internationally acclaimed cultural center was established here in 1995 and meanwhile also the Folklore Festival. It was like Woodstock, but with better weather. No mud wrestling.
Wiesbaden is certainly not the easiest city in which to establish a progressive culture, but we have struggled for a showcase and we've gained the trust and support of the city.
I believe that the attraction of a city rests on the fact that sometimes astonishing things can happen here. That something wholly unexpected occurs. For example, we had an opera here in the Schlachthof. Last year we invited an Australian opera group to take part in the May festivals, a company that performed the magic flute. It was a fantastic performance, and I'm sure that the setting plus the classical opera made an unforgettable impression on everyone.
Das bleibt den Leuten in Erinnerung.
The Kurhaus and the Rhein-Main-Hallen are wonderful locations, and if we can put on something there in the next few years, I believe it would make an exciting contribution to the cultural life of Wiesbaden.
During our weekly brainstorming sessions, everyone could throw in their 10 cents. Then someone, I don't remember who, said, we could sell the darkness. Because the castle was walled up, we always had to climb the staircase with flashlights. Only at the top did any light come in. Then he went on, we can sell the darkness. We'll do an exhibition. They won't see anything. That's what we did.
Ja, so haben wir es gemacht. Da ist eine Schlange.
There's a queue. We're waiting until we get in. What's in there? We replied, well, it's an exhibition. Well, what can we see? Nothing. No, we still want to have a look. And we had 25,000 visitors.
25,000 Besucher.
There's a wonderful Swiss saying, when the cow shits, wait until the cowpat dries before you pick it up. And then you can do lots of things with it. Don't touch it too soon. One has to test it. And that's what we still do today.
The International May Festivals have taken place since 1896. With over 800 performances a year and approximately 300,000 visitors, how can something like this be financially viable?
The state should always help! The state!
Hans-Christian Bremer is chairman of the fundraising committee. He's a key partner in this context. Without the 130,000 euro, which this benefactor and his colleagues in this committee bring in, it would not be possible to invite and finance many a top performer or theatre company.
Tolle Highlight nicht zu einzuladen und nicht zu finanzieren.
You find that culture is at its most creative in the provinces, because that is where new things are tried out.
In case you hadn't noticed, that's not us.
No, yes, but...
Talent develops outside the capitals, and only after it has had its rough edges smoothed off and fought its way through, might it get to the major cities.
Kommen Sie vielleicht in die Metropole.
You don't know everything!
Engagement with the avant-garde in culture, theatre and language flourishes in Wiesbaden. Likewise in the historic Villa Clementine, which today serves as a house of literature.
There has to be a balance. There's always a good mix. You'll find many small initiatives. They're not necessarily always societies. There are loose networks of literature lovers. For example, in the Poets District, you'll find poetry fans. We also have literary conferences here in Wiesbaden, and you'll find societies such as the Dante Society. It's a very lively and varied scene.
Es ist eine sehr lebendige Szene.
The principle of the Poetry Slam is that the performance is also evaluated. So it's an event where you register in advance, and then anyone can go onto the stage and either recite a text they've written themselves, or they can do free improvisation.
Think of the scenic beauty of Dresden. Think of the Mediterranean charm of Freiburg. Think of the intellectual power of Wiesbaden.
And
after 20 years away, I was standing here again and I thought, I belong here. I have to be here. And that's a marvelous feeling.
Ein tolles Gefühl.
The open-air concerts are wonderful too. I've been engaged by the Rheingau Music Festival and I'll be involved and contribute.
After failing my music studies, I thought I'd be a great singer. But that was not to be. So I thought, no, better stay in management or go into management before you fail as a singer somewhere. Michael Herrmann has been the man pulling the strings behind the Rheingau Music Festival since 1988, with 140 concerts a year in the Rheingau and in Wiesbaden. R.E.M., Sting or Nelly Furtado, Placido Domingo, Rod Stewart or Elton John, they've all performed in the unique setting of the Bowling Green. These concerts draw huge crowds from the whole of the Rhein-Main region. Several times a year, there is the opportunity to do a tour of the art centers and make merry during the short night of the galleries and museums and during the Fototage.
I believe that on days like this, for instance, during Fototage, we can show that Wiesbaden has more to offer than hearing aid shops and nursing homes, and that the city has vitality, even if what it has culturally is not immediately obvious.
The art collection, with works from Expressionism to the present day, as well as the natural history collection. These are the two great pillars of the city's largest museum.
Jawlensky is an artistic saint revered at all levels in Wiesbaden. I've had the good fortune of being able to build up this collection to the point where it is now the most substantial and one of the best in the world. If you like, I have here a monument to genius that is known worldwide and which brings great credit to the region and the city. We were Museum of the Year in 2007. We have won international awards for our exhibitions. In 2002, the American EICA awarded us Best Monograph Exhibition in the World for our Eva Hesse exhibition. In 2008, the US Publishers Association voted our publications Best Book in America in the Fine Art category, and so on and so forth.
Bestes Buch Amerikas in der Kategorie Fine Art, und so weiter und so weiter.
So the city is going to build a city museum. Plans are in existence. And the museum will bring together different artifacts from both archaeology and history to create a wonderfully unified concept.
Its cultural diversity is ever present. This perhaps is the greatest chance that Wiesbaden has ever had.